Hi guys, my name is Fabio Davenia, detailer of Mafra, and here with us is Giacomo, our chemist.
Hello everybody.
Who will give us more details about BIOXYSTEAM.
BIOXYSTEAM is a revolutionary product based on a peroxide compound able to release active oxygen. This active oxygen inactivates viruses and destroys bacteria. But how does it work? BIOXYSTEAM is the only product that can be used inside a steam boiler, in this case in the Geyser steam system. Why? Because the steam system first of all converts the product. So it works just like a real reactor. The product converted inside the steam system will be much more active, and therefore we will have a high concentration of active oxygen. Furthermore, once the product has been converted by the Geyser steam system, it is completely safe for surfaces, easily biodegradable, and above all, it does not leave any kind of residue.
It is therefore a one-of-a-kind product since we are lucky enough to be able to put it inside the boiler. This is very important because with other products this is not possible. So I can safely put it in the boiler, there's absolutely no problem. On the contrary, it gives me a number of benefits because it helps me to keep the boiler clean from any impurities and to eliminate limescale residues.
Now, let me show you scientifically what I've just said. Let me demonstrate how the BIOXYSTEAM product is transformed inside the Geyser steam system.
Therefore, during the boiler transit and afterwards at the dispensing point.
I'll use a simple instrument, a pH meter, which measures pH values.
So we'll measure pH before and after transit.
Exactly. So first of all, we'll dilute the product. Normal dilutions for healthcare environments where major purification is required are from 1 to 20 and from 1 to 40 in non-healthcare environments.
In case of having to carry out any decontamination, a 1 to 20 dilution could be fine considering in any case that I'm not sure what I shall find inside.
Now we'll prefer an intermediate dilution from 1 to 30.
So what are we going to do now, Giacomo?
Here is the can from where the Geyser steam system will take the diluted product, in this case 1 to 30. And we'll use the pH meter and directly submerge the electrode to measure the pH value. Okay, we have obtained a stable reading. The pH is 3.23 at a temperature of about 20 degrees Celsius.
Giacomo, after BIOXYSTEAM has passed through the boiler, what do you expect to happen?
Well, in theory, I expect the pH to have risen by at least one logarithmic unit. This is because the peroxide compound has passed through the Geyser system boiler and has therefore been transformed in what we cannot but call a mini-reactor, and we shall therefore have a product coming out of the Geyser system itself with a higher pH, and this goes to show conversion into simple water and acetic acid. Obviously active oxygen that will have destroyed the bacteria and deactivated the virus. Now I shall proceed to condense a little steam inside this glass betcher so as to be able to measure the pH at exit. Now we shall submerge the probe inside the condensed steam. Let's switch on the instrument. Let's wait for self-calibration and then measure the pH, which is 4.36. This result, that is the change in pH from 3.23 to 4.36, shows that inside the Geyser steam system, inside the boiler itself, there is a sort of reaction, a conversion of the peroxide system into active oxygen.
Now Giacomo, after seeing how the product works, give us a few tips on how to use it.
First of all, the pure product, as you can clearly see from the label, is hazardous, because it is a very concentrated product, with a strong purifying action. But once it has been diluted for use, in a range from 1 to 20 and from 1 to 40, the product loses all its hazardousness. What is more, the peroxide compound, including when diluted, remains blandly corrosive and potentially hazardous for some types of surfaces. So the most important piece of advice I can give you is to use the product through the Geyser boiler. Because the boiler is able to convert
the sum of the product.
Exactly. So once the product has been transformed, we'll no longer have any corrosion problem.
Okay, so what you are saying is that by transforming it in the boiler, I benefit when it comes to user safety and with regards to use in general.
Absolutely, yes. And then as you said, as regards plastics, the final solution with slightly acid pH is able to improve the appearance, improve purification and improve cleansing. above all by acting on any possible porosities we find on that type of surface. Once the product has been transformed by the Geyser boiler, it is safe to use on any type of fabric. And what is more, the product does not leave any residue at all.
So I'll find myself with a completely finished surface, but without any residue.
Exactly.
After this overview of BIOXYSTEAM, we'll now go on to perform a number of tests to confirm the effectiveness of the product on surfaces. How should we perform these tests, Giacomo?
We'll use an instrument called bioluminometer, which produces a result in just 10 seconds.
So we won't have to wait for a very long time as usual, 48 to 72 hours?
Absolutely not. The bioluminometer measures the bioluminescence produced by the bacteria. Bioluminescence is expressed in RLU, relative luminescence unit.
Giacomo, what are these RLUs? A plate. It's not lunchtime.
I'll explain this using this plate. First of all, we'll contaminate the plate with organic residues, in this case with salami. We'll expect the surface of the plate to be contaminated with a large bacterial load. Once the plate has been contaminated, we'll measure the exact degree of contamination. Now, we'll clean the plate using a standard plate detergent. After rinsing, we dry it. Now, we'll measure the bacterial contamination on the plate again. This way, we'll see the difference before and after contamination. This way, we'll see the RLUs on a plate we consider to be clean. That is, ready for eating off again. So, at the end of the test, we see that a completely contaminated plate has an RLU value of around 435,000.
That's a lot.
What a clean plate has a bacterial contamination level of 6,985 RLUs.
So 7,000 is a good result, isn't it, Giacomo?
No, in actual fact, with a value of 7,000, this plate is very contaminated. Guidelines show that a rough surface represents the highest degree of contamination, because it is much easier for microorganisms to remain inside the roughness. A surface can be considered purified at around 500, 600, and therefore much below 7,000.
The value is around 10 times higher.
Exactly, and for very smooth surfaces, such as the ceramic surface of the plate, the value at which we can consider it purified is even lower, around 200, 300 RLUs.
Okay, so at this point we go even higher, 20 times higher than the standard value.
Finally, in operating rooms, where the environment must be almost sterile, the limit is around 50 RLUs.
Well, Giacomo, thanks for giving us this overview of BIOXYSTEAM and the bioluminometer. So let's get on with the tests.
We start the tests by splitting the surfaces into two parts. First of all, we'll check the BIOXYSTEAM area before treatment. After passing the swab over the surface, we'll combine it with the reagent, shaking the bottle. Next, we'll insert it in the measuring instrument and wait 10 seconds for the result. And here's the first result, a reading of 98,541 RLUs. Now we'll go on to test the second surface, which we'll treat with normal steam. As we did before, we'll perform the test by passing the swab over the surface. Next, we'll combine it with the reagent, shake it, and insert it in the measuring device. After waiting 10 seconds, here is the result. 26,821 RLUs against 98,541. Before performing the test, we'll dilute BIOXYSTEAM. In this case, we'll choose a dilution of 1 to 20, a good dilution for excellent vehicle decontamination. Now let's begin testing, starting with BIOXYSTEAM. We'll dispense it onto the surface at a distance of 30 centimeters, so the heat does not alter the end results. Now we'll dry the surface without leaving any halos and leaving a perfect finish. After drying the surface, we'll perform the test again, so as to understand the condition of the area after the transit of BIOXYSTEAM. 10 seconds after measuring, we find a value of 1,642 RLUs compared to the initial 98,541, 98% less contamination. Now we'll treat the other half of the surface with steam using plain boiler water. After using the steam, we'll dry the surface with a jet of air so as not to alter the results. After drying the surface, we can check it over. This way we can appreciate just how decontaminating the steam has been. Now, just like on the other surface, we'll straight away carry out a check after drying so as to avoid any contamination over time. And here is the result, 15,274 RLUs. Just 43% compared to the initial situation. The difference is very clear, with a surface 10 times more purified. Now let us go to the second test and perform the procedure suggested by the Istituto Superiore di Sanità, International Institute of Health. We'll perform both cleaning and purifying. First of all, let's check the conditions of the surface so as to see just how contaminated it is. The initial reading on this surface is 60,093 RLUs. To ensure proper purification, we'll first of all clean with an alkaline APC. In this case, the brush will help us penetrate deeper to ensure good purification. After cleaning, we'll check the surface again to see how much the RLU level has gone down. And here is the result after cleaning. 435 RLU, 99% less compared to initial contamination. Afterwards, we finish our test by going over with BIOXYSTEAM. This will help us finish the job. After going over with BIOXYSTEAM, we'll finish off the surface and perform the swab test. And here we are with the final measurements after cleaning and going over with BIOXYSTEAM. And this is the final measurement. We have 32 RLUs, a truly extraordinary result. 99.9% less compared to the initial contamination.
Well, Giacomo, as you can see, we finished the tests, but I wanted to ask you a question. How do you explain the plate reading we obtained straight after washing?
Look, it's simple. As you quite rightly noticed, the contamination value, that is, the RLU value found on the plate just washed, was even higher than the RLU found inside the car.
That's right.
You might ask yourself, how is that possible? If you noticed, after we finished washing the plate, we cleaned it with a dishcloth.
Okay, now I remember.
That dishcloth, if you remember, was damp, had been used, and probably someone also used it to dry themselves.
Of course, it sometimes happens that you dry your hands and perhaps something else.
So how you use cloths is very important. You have to be careful how you use them after doing any purification. In fact, the plate was probably clean, and we went on to contaminate the surface using a dirty dishcloth. That's what happens if you use a dirty cloth, the end of the purifying process. Now, if you want, we can sum up the various phases of the cleaning process. The first phase is cleaning, the hardest of all. As the tests went to show, if we first of all use a detergent, we have a clear advantage at the end of the operation. This makes the subsequent purifying operation easier. What we are interested in most is the percentage of bacterial load reduced during the process. So if we are in any case above 90%, that is a good result. The absolute RLU value is of interest when we set the limit. That is 500, 600 for what we then find on the surface of the motor vehicle. That is the parameter which enables us to understand if it is in fact a surface, irrespective of the reduced bacterial load, which is really being purified or not. By just plain cleaning, it is very hard to achieve a value of 500, 600.
Of course.
So you can reduce a good portion of the bacterial load, even over 90%. But then to this relative data, we must add the fact that without a purifier, it's almost impossible to achieve the values we determine between 500 and 600. Values that for us represent a truly clean surface.
The problem is dropping below 1,000, because you know, guys, that is the most difficult phase. So as we have seen, we've managed to drop below 50, and that's not easy at all. So in that case, you have to use the right products to ensure the bacterial load drops significantly.
You have to use the right products, respect the application times, the application and action times. If necessary, respect the dilutions of use, and above all, always be careful. Therefore, always work with gloves, possibly with a face mask, so as not to contaminate the surface, and always remember to use clean cloths. If you're not sure they have been purified, treat them beforehand with a purifying product.
Perfect, Giacomo. Thanks for your help and see you at the next video.
Bye.
Bye, guys.